Alright, so we're doing a clap. Wait, why are you dressed normal, like your everyday attire? We were doing a witch movie. You said we were going to do the most famous and beloved witch horror movie ever made.
And that's exactly what we're going to be doing.
I thought we agreed we were going to do a craft thing. We were going to, Nancy and you were going to do...
Where the fuck is Tim Daly in the craft?
The guy from Wings? Okay, so we're doing the, you meant the Vavitch. I misunderstood. But this will still work. You meant the Vavitch, right?
Is Tim Daly in the Vavitch?
The guy from Wings? Again, the guy from Wings?
Yes, the guy from Wings. You know, the guy that stood next to Weber Wang.
We already did Warlock earlier this year. What fucking movie are you talking about? We're not doing The Wizard of Oz, are we? That seems weird.
God, no. Blessings onto all of your houses, and welcome to another one of our 31 days. And tonight are we bringing you a spellcastingly good movie all the way from 1988, a very underrepresented and under-talked about film called Spellbinder.
What?
So if you want to hear about it, stick around. Witchy woman.
I thought we were doing the craft.
No, we're not.
What the fuck?
We're never doing the craft, darling. We will never.
That's what she said, knowing exactly what's coming next year. For purposes of video, what the fuck is Spellbinder, please?
So Spellbind, as if you don't know.
I for purposes of this weird bit, no, I don't know what this movie is. What is Spellbinder?
Okay, so I'm kind of starting.
And what does the guy from Wings have to do with it?
Patience.
I'm not good at that. I will start stabbing.
So what this? So I'm sure, much like Christian, I'm sure some of you out there in YouTube land might be a little confused. This is keeping up with our Halloween tradition. You remember last year how I showed you a really out there movie that I thought a few people actually said they really remembered it. The Kiss. You remember
that
movie?
Yeah, I like The Kiss. The Kiss was fun.
Yeah. Well, this year I'm keeping that connection because I wanted to show you a movie that is super under talked about, super underrated, is a witch movie. We'll have a connection with our horror hangouts, which will be also tonight on Monty G's channel, but
shameless plug.
But this is a movie that the Church of Scientology does not want you to know about.
What?
And not only that, I'm always here to piss off all the Scientologists, but mostly I'm here because this is a movie, much like The Kiss, is one of those movies that no one ever talks about when we're talking witches movies, and this movie is fucking awesome. Now, there you will see some things coming. We'll get into it. You'll definitely notice some tropes.
Yeah, I guess to pull back the illusion of having not seen this movie. Yeah, no, you showed me this movie the other night, and yeah, no, this was an interesting one. I'll be straight up. I think I did out of the two. They're very different movies, granted, but I did do think I prefer. I like The Kiss just a little bit more, but I did really enjoy Spellbinder. This was a really fun little movie that I can totally see why you and it seems like a lot of other people would have a lot of fond memories of if you caught it on cable one night.
Yes, and see, another reason why I feel it's very appropriate to add it to our 31 days, other than a shameless connection and plug to our horror outs, which by the way will be at so-and-so time tonight, the reason why is because I actually saw this movie, it played on cable on either Skinamax or HBO when I was a kid on Halloween night. It was at the very end of the night, and I was a little insomniac girl, and I remember catching this movie, and I was just blown away. Little Jen, and I was shocked by the twist. Now, if I was watching this movie now, I could tell you, I could see everything coming, but Little Jen was like, oh, wow, and like, this movie, and this is probably gonna get me killed, especially since I'm a 90s girl, and considering how you're dressed up, you look lovely, by the way.
I will start stabbing you.
You look lovely, by the way, but blasphemous as this might sound, this is my witch movie. This movie had way more of an impact on me than The Craft ever did. Like, this is the movie. Little Jen wanted to be Kelly Preston in this movie, and I'm like...
Wanted to marry John Travolta?
No, but it got me interested in the occult. Like, my mother is a practicing Wiccan, so I've always been around it, but this was the movie that made it seem very, very cool.
This movie I think a lot of, especially horror fans, are going to see where this movie is ultimately going. But if you're fairly new to the horror genre or haven't seen a lot of stuff, this movie might surprise you. I don't want to spoil it, but let's just say this movie takes heavy influence from one of the more well-known and beloved films from the Hammer catalog.
Yes, very much so.
And it does it really well. Like, even knowing that that was probably where we're going to end up going by, like, I suspected very early on we were going to go into sort of that direction, but then I fully realized, oh, we're doing this movie about the halfway point. I still really found myself enjoying and looking forward to seeing how we were going to get to that point and what we were going to do building up to it. It does a really good job of getting you invested.
It really does. And remember what I said? I wasn't joking when I said that Church of Scientology, this is why you might never have heard about this movie. They tried to bury it.
Yes.
Because our lead is, besides Tim Daly, our other lead is Kelly Preston. And I forgot, like, I knew she was married to John Travolta, but I didn't really make much of a connection. I just always knew her. Oh, she's the Arnold Schwarzenegger's girlfriend in Twins.
You never think, like, wait a second. And then, like, then thinking about, like, what this movie's about, at least on the offset of, like, it's about a woman trying to escape this crazy wackadoo fucking cult in L.A. Of a bunch of crazy rich people. You're like, oh, I think I understand why the Church of Scientology wanted to ban this movie after she became a member. They bought up a bunch of VHS copies and burned them. They really wanted to destroy this movie, which is funny given how readily available it is. It's on Tubi, it's on YouTube, it's a very easy movie. I don't know about a physical copy, but at least it's very easy to watch still.
Yes, but it's a movie that, again, and we're going to be talking about which movies tonight, and I feel like probably no one is going to know what we're talking about.
No.
And I feel that there's a lot of people, unless you happen to catch it on cable as a kid, I feel that it was very much under the radar.
I had never heard of this movie. When you told me about this movie, because this wasn't a movie, this is a prime example of grab bag. This wasn't a movie we were planning on doing this
eventually.
Month. We were just going to watch, she was just showing it to me as like getting ready for horror hangouts. So I had never heard of this film. I thought, when you were telling me about it, I thought you were talking about fucking Spellcaster from Full Moon, which has a bunch of like new wave artists in it. I thought that was the movie you were talking about. I was like, yeah, the movie's pretty alright, but nothing particularly exceptional or anything. So I had never heard of this film before, which is weird because, like, I'm actually kind of, I like Wings a lot, so you would have thought I would have heard of a time Tim Daly was the lead in a horror movie.
Yes, and he is really good.
He's good.
Much like Steven Weber, who has a little bit more of a horror pedigree, but Tim Daly can hold his own. And don't let me oversell this movie, guys. Like, it's a very fun movie. But, like, it's not so much the story, again, especially if you're a seasoned horror fan, you're gonna know probably all the plot beats to it. But, like, I think you're gonna be a lot like Christian, guys. Even though you probably have a good, at least strong suspicion of where we're going with this, the ride is still really fun. And that is the whole cast. There's a lot of character actors in this movie, and Kelly Preston and Tim Daly have really great chemistry.
They do.
And Kelly Preston, again, like, I'm not kidding when I say this movie,
she's a vibe.
She really, for me as a little girl, and even watching it all these years later, really taps into that feminine, witchy woman vibe, that woman of the earth and the land. There is a scene where she literally burns her hands. She's taking a hot turkey out of the oven, and she sticks her hands in ice and does a blessing, and you buy it!
Absolutely. This movie has a really cool, like, occult feel to it. And it also, like, not only just talking about the witchos, this movie also has a lot of great, and I say this in the best ways possible, this movie has a lot of 80s cheese, very similar to The Kiss. There's a lot, if you just want a fun movie that has a lot of weird, kind of goofy moments in that you can kind of have a laugh about with, this movie has it for you. There's a great moment towards the end of the film where fucking Tim Daly is breaking into this fucking mansion, and you got this older couple of like this bickering wife and husband who are fucking cult members.
This is upper middle class.
Rich fuckers. And they're bickering and fucking hate each other. And then fucking with Tim Daly's like, okay, tell me what I need to know and stuff. And then their fucking daughter, instead of like doing some sort of spell to like take down Tim Daly, no, she just comes and judo kicks him and fucking has a karate fight with him and stuff. It's really fun. Like, it's a really fun zig where the movie thinks you would zag. There's a lot of stuff like that. I love the bit where, like, I watched this movie and I still don't know what the fuck this was about. Like, I can kind of make an assumption, but, like, there's a random point where we're just stalking some random dude we've never seen in the movie and never gets mentioned again, where people are just, like, fucking stalking him a la fucking Logan's Run was kind of what I was thinking of. And then he just gets set on fire for no reason at the end of the scene, and it's never mentioned again, but it's cool.
One of the things that I like that we haven't hit upon yet is, yes, the Kelly Preston is an amazing, like, witch, and that's a really smart idea, but I think where some movies might fumble the ball, what this movie adds into it, which adds another layer in the fun and the camp and just the overall enjoyment, and it adds another layer of story, is we also have a coven, and we're not just dealing with a witch.
It's an entire cult coven.
It's a whole coven, and how she is literally casting her spell is she is trying to get out of this coven.
Yeah,
she has an abusive boyfriend.
She has an abusive boyfriend.
who's a cult leader.
Who's like the cult leader. Great actor, by the way. Dude doesn't do a lot in the movie, but I really remember performance. And then Tim Daly, who's just this random lawyer, stumbles upon her getting beaten by him. He's like, fuck you, wizard man. I'm taking your girlfriend. And he's like, the prophecy, you don't know what the prophecy you have awoken shall be, my friend. Good day, sir. And then he's like, cool, bet, I'm gonna fuck your girlfriend now. And he does, and then him and Kelly Preston get married and fucking all that stuff, and then the cult kind of comes back into it. But it's really fun.
It really is, and like the coven aspect is so much fun, and like I love his performance because like if you're an observant movie watcher, you'd be like, you know, this guy, he's not exactly as authentic as a warlock should be, a coven member should be, and the movie kind
but
of
then
reveals
you see
his
him,
cars.
Yeah, but then you also see him later on in the movie fucking set a guy on fire with just staring at him like he's a fucking, like he's Brad Dourif in Spontaneous Combustion or some shit.
And again, there's a lot of side characters that I love that I'm not going to go too big because I really do want you guys.
This isn't one where we're going to give you like a plot-by-plot synopsis of this one.
No, it's just this is a movie, things aren't much what they seem, and yeah, you probably are going to figure it out, but even if you do, it's a fun ride, guys. But I do have to talk a few of other aspects of the movie because I really do hope you guys will check this one out. One of the other aspects is there is another coven member who happens to be Kelly Preston's mother, and oh my god, this
Mrs.
actress,
Wright.
This actually plays into another Halloween because I swear to god,
she does
mother's boy
she does
stole this scene.
Yeah, she does the exact same thing that Jamie Lee Curtis does in that fucking movie. It was really fun to see. I love Mrs. White's actress. She did a really good job here.
Yeah, and I'm legitimately wondering if someone from that movie
knows,
saw it.
Who knows? My favorite of the random side characters in this movie that don't really amount to anything, but I'm like, that's cool, is Prototype Burt Gummer.
I figured.
I loved this fucking character. He's
Brock!
Brock. He has like two scenes in this movie, but he's like this weird paramilitary guy
Tim Daly.
He's this weird paramilitary guy that Tim Daly helps like with some legal issue.
He's rich!
Yeah, he's a rich,
crazy
rich paramilitary guy that Tim Daly helps get out of some issues, and then they go back to go to his like strong compound later on when they're trying to escape the coven and stuff. He only has like two scenes in this movie, but holy fuck, this actor makes this such a memorable character and honestly does give me like a strong feeling of like a prototype Burt Gummer almost, of like this weird, super eccentric, fuck the government paramilitary dude, but not like in a crazy racist bigoted way, just, you know, like a not weirdly leftist, not like just fuck the government trying to tell people what to do, I have my guns kind of way. I really enjoyed that character. Also, just a random thing for me, that actor also played a very, very small part in the movie Bit, which anyone who's watched this channel knows I fucking adore Bit, so
I didn't know that was...
always will be happy to see. Yeah, I didn't either, but I was like, that actor looks weirdly familiar. Lo and behold, he's a bouncer in one scene of Bit, so like, fuck yeah, I love Bit.
Oh, so he's still working, that's very cool. Yeah, he does make his presence in a very small role, and for whenever I think of this particular character from this movie, I always just hear him say, fucking A!
Fucking A!
he just says it in this really, you know, like Hulk Hogan kind of vibe.
Yeah,
to
he
it.
He's kind of a mixture of like Burt Gummer and Jesse Ventura's character from Predator.
Yes.
He's kind of a mixture.
Exactly.
You can totally hear this guy going sexual Tyrannosaurus. You can totally hear that.
Yes, another character, and this is like a trope we've seen in a lot of movies, but whenever I'm watching Audition, this character reminds me. I know.
I'm sorry, what?
Weird parallel, but we have this motherly figure to Tim Daly because you find out, his family's dead. His family's dead, but he has this secretary who's like this motherly figure, and he has this party, and everybody is just falling in love with Kelly Preston, which isn't hard to do.
No.
Even when she's not taking off her top. Beautiful wreck, by the way.
Also, yes, you do see Kelly Preston's tits for one scene in this movie, if you're interested, if that's appealing to you.
She was another one that I've got on my tape. If we ever win the lottery where I'm taking it to the doctor and go, could you make it look like these? But anyway, the secretary, she's this very motherly woman to Tim Daly, and like I said, everybody else really likes her, but she's that same way with the friend from Audition. Something about this bitch I don't like, Tim Daly. I don't trust her. Probably because she's the one that sees Kelly Preston literally taking out a hot turkey out of the oven without any fucking mitts. And
that's
she tries,
fine.
And I love the scene she has with Tim Daly, because she hems and haws and she goes, no, I don't like her. She fucking takes out a turkey with her bare hands. Something's not right with that bitch.
Nope,
I'm paraphrasing, but that's the vibe.
That's basically how she performs, and it's really great. That actress, it's interesting. This movie has such, like, a fairly strong, like, yeah, Tim Daly's the lead, but, like, it has a very strong feminine prominent cast in it, honestly, with a lot of the side characters and the more prominent roles in the film, which honestly makes sense, knowing this is one of those weird 80s horror movies that is led exclusively by women. We have a female writer and a female director for this one.
Oh, God, did I pick a woke horror
you
movie from 1988?
But, yeah, it's one of those, this is one of those weird little, like, cult B movies, very similar to stuff like Blood Diner, where, like, surprise, they're actually, like, super female-driven horror films, and, like, a very early adopter of, like, female directors trying to break into the horror scene.
Yeah, it is. There's actually another, we haven't seen this one.
Director has another movie, which I definitely want to fucking check out, that's a rape revenge film that you'll probably hear us talk about sometime in the future.
And what I really find interesting is she wrote it under a man's
name. Yeah, she wrote it under a male pseudonym, so it'll be interesting, but we'll talk about that some other time in the near future.
But this movie, like, again, I don't want to oversell it, but it's not as campy as The Kiss.
No.
We've kind of gone down a little bit, but there are some scenes that are very fun, very over the top, very much of the 80s, but and the story is very predictable, but there's just something about, this movie has stayed with me since I was about 8 or 9, 7, somewhere in that area. I've never forgot it, and I'm not being funny. This was my craft movie. This was like the one that opened me up to witchcraft.
I can understand. They're very different films, but I can totally get where you're coming from, and I had a really good time with this one. Just because I preferred The Kiss from last year is not a criticism towards this movie. I still had a really fun time with this one. It's a really good to watch, and I totally recommend checking it out. I give this movie a positive. I had fun with it, and that's all I can ask for sometimes. Really worth checking out. It's readily available on both Tubi as well as a rip on YouTube.
This is one that I kind of hold near, for not the same way as like something like Pet Sematary or some of my more serious films, but this is one of those ones.
It was a stepstone in your horror journey.
It was. It was, and in my religious journey in a weird
way.
There you
go.
Because I was like, I want to be like her, and if you've seen the end of the movie, you're going to laugh, but yes, I totally wanted to be like, I was like, oh my God.
Oh no, end of the movie, Kelly Preston's even more of a vibe than beginning of the movie, Kelly Preston.
She is life goals, and I just love the power she, and I never got to achieve that power she had over men, but oh God, I wanted to have that witchy power over men. That was like, little Jen was like, oh, I want to be like her when I grow up.
Yeah, absolutely.
But this is a movie I give a solid A to, and again, probably nostalgia is, but the thing I found interesting, the few people that do remember this, most of them really remember it really fondly,
yeah.
Which really made me happy. I thought I was the only one, but I think a lot of you guys out there have never heard of this one. Definitely checking it out. Like Christian said, readily available. It's fun, and it's really, like I said, the first time I saw it was either the tail end of Halloween or the very early hours of November 1st. And it was the last thing they were playing before they went to their kids block, and I was here for it.
I can see that. This is a great movie for that kind of time block.
It really is, and I think that is all we have to say about Spellbinder, but go tell the Scientology, go fuck yourselves by seeing this movie.
Absolutely. Yeah, you're pissing off the Church of Scientology by watching this movie. So
you're doing a good thing.
What's there not to love? And if you also want to piss off the Church of Scientology, come down to Horrorhead. Come on down to the Horror Miser Monty G's channel later tonight to hear us talk about more movies of witchcraft and exorcisms, but mostly witchcraft.
and we have the fabulous Rainbow Fright
yes,
on.
We're going to have a lovely guest. It's going to be a really good time. Our Halloween special. You know our Halloween shows are always a load of fun. So yeah, come on down if you're interested to the Horror Miser Monty G's channel this time.
Oh dear me! I have to get into a proper costume! I'm in my regular clothes! Oh dear me! We gotta go, guys! So we wish everyone another fun-filled day of spooky weed. We wish you another happy day of our 31 Days of Halloween. Be sure to check out all the other channels. We love you guys. Remember, spooky season comes but once a year. So go fuck something else. I've already told them to go fuck a pumpkin. Go fuck something else spooky. Or go have sex with spooky music. Go have sex to, like, the Ramones Pet Cemetery. That's kind of odd. Or witchy woman. No, because it's a witchy. Go have sex to witchy woman.
And then after you're done, come down to Horror Hangouts.
And... you said come down.
Oh, God damn it. Okay, I'm stabbing you. Stab. Okay, we're done now. Yeah, so see you at Horror Hangouts. You're dead. You're dead. We're going away. I'm doing it now. Fuck you. You're dead. Yeah, no, so come on down to Horror Hangouts. It'll be a hoot and a holler. See you tomorrow on our end. Bye, everyone. You're dead. 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 Dead.